Hello, my name is Nicolas Bonan. Welcome to this first tutorial about OVS2Box. OVS2Box is a GUI for OpenVSwitch. I am going to demonstrate how to create this virtual network where you can see two bridges, six Docker containers, and three VLANs. Let's go to the GitHub page of OVS2Box. Please read install file. OVS2Box depends on some libraries that you need to install. To download the whole project with its source code included, press clone. Alternatively, if you just want the binary, click on ovs2box.py and save it. Go into a terminal, start OpenVSwitch service, start Docker service, and then launch OVS2Box. We need to create two management profiles, one for each bridge. Let's give a name for first profile, mgmt_br0. We will manage on localhost by sudo a bridge br0. Second profile, br1 is also on localhost and manageable by sudo. Let's select first profile and press plus button to create br0. Now select second profile and press again plus to create br1. Go to plotnet config and press refresh to plot current network configuration. We can see br0 and br1 bridges. Let's remove unnecessary items from this graph. Just put in filter out field what you don't want to plot. You can also import your favorite unwanted words. Now let's create three Docker containers, doc01, 02, 03. Pay attention to IP, MAC addresses and port names. Select br0 profile, go to Docker, Docker image, press refresh to list your images. I will take a Fedora image, go to Docker run, enter a container name, doc something. Enter Docker option or directly import them from your favorite options. Press iterate container from 01 to 03. Validate. This will create three containers. Let's connect to first container doc01. We can see that no network has been configured so far. That is absolutely normal because of net non-Docker option that we specified. So now let's create an interface template for our containers. Push plus button, enter OVS port name P something, container interface name inside container if0, MAC address AA00000000 something. With this interface selected, press plus button to add an IP to this if0 interface, select IP address, enter 10.0.0.something/24, validate. Now push network setup iteration button. Pay attention, this is not the same iterate button as before. From 01 to 03, validate. This will set up networking for doc01, 02 and 03 containers. Go into doc01 container. We see that if0 interface has been created with correct IP and MAC addresses. In plotnet config, press refresh. We see our three containers connected to br0 switch through ports p01, p02 and p03. In ports section, press refresh, we can see br0 ports, p01, p02, p03. We still need to create containers doc04, 05, 06. Select communication profile for br1 switch, go into Docker, iterate creation of containers, from 04 to 06, validate. Three new containers are running. Press Network Setup Iteration button, validate. in.NET config press refresh. Doc 04, 05 and 06 containers are now network connected to beer 1. We still need to connect beer 1 to beer 0. We need to create PI port on beer 0 and PB port on beer 1 and to connect them. Let's select beer 0 comme profile, go to port section, new port PA, validate. Select PI port, select interface type, select patch, peer type PB, validate. Select beer 1 comme profile, go to port section, refresh, new port PB, validate. Select PB port, select interface type, select patch, peer type PA, validate. In.NET config, press refresh. We now see that beer 0 is connected to beer 1 via a virtual patch cable. Our network is nearly done, all 6 containers are connected. We still need to add some VLANs. Currently, any container can ping any other container. For example, we see that Doc01 can ping Doc02. Soon, we will make this impossible by adding VLANs. Select beer 0 comme profile, go to port section, refresh, select port P1, select VLAN section, tag enter 100, mode by default is access, you don't have to change it. Validate. Select port P2, tag 150, validate. Select port P3, tag 200, validate. Select port PA, 100,150, select trunk, validate. Select com profile for BR1, select port section, refresh, select port 4, tag 100, validate. Select port 5, tag 150, validate. Select port P6, tag 200, validate. Select port PB, 100,150, select trunk, validate. Oops, something went wrong as you can see from the red light. It's because I have mistakenly chosen tag field instead of trunk field. Press console button if you want to see logs. So let's do it again and apply correct config this time. Go into .NET config, press refresh. We can see that every container connection is correctly tagged now. We can also see trunk with allowed VLANs between beer 0 and beer 1. Let's see if we can still ping doc 2 from doc 1. No, it is blocked. We cannot ping doc 3 either. We can ping doc 4, that's normal as they are on the same VLAN. And we cannot ping neither doc 5 nor doc 6. Everything works as expected. We have shown that doc 1 and doc 4, who are both on VLAN 100, are able to ping each other. I'd like to come back to output console interface. In this console, you find all command lines that have been generated by OVS Toolbox and sent to open vSwitch during this demonstration. Now let's clean everything. In Docker section, select all containers and trash them. Go to port section, press refresh, select ports P4 to PB and delete them. Then select BR0 com profile, go to port section, select P1 to PA and delete them. Go to .NET config and refresh, we have nothing left except BR0 and BR1. Go to bridge section, press trash to delete current bridge. Go to com profile and select BR1 profile. Come back to bridge section and press trash to delete BR1 bridge. This is all for today. Thanks for watching this video. Bye.